Right, I haven't done one of these for a while. The last couple live streams I've done have been some of those abstract paintings, but this is a present for someone. Portrait of the late Chester Bennington. I never really listened to Linkin Park, but this friend of mine really, really likes him. So I thought I'd do this, and it's one of those paintings that it's not necessarily for a client, so there's really no pressure that I feel. I can sort of play around with it. There are no expectations. So I can sort of do what I want. And I was going to do a watercolor, but I changed my mind. So I'm going to use the old FW inks. And we'll see how it goes. And if you hear little noises, I'm sorry. I have a Jolly Rancher in me mouth. So every once in a while, you'll hear some little tiny smacking. And hopefully all this crazy color stuff will come together as I hope and plan for it to. What am I listening to, you say? You ask? Well, at the moment, it's Dead Can Dance right after some Miles Davis. I heard that the great Jack Davis died, I guess today. I saw a post about it, although I guess I shouldn't necessarily rely on that, but that's a pretty big deal. He's been around for a long time and obviously was one of the main gang of idiots at Mad Magazine. For the longest time. I expect we'll see another amazing portrait by Bill Sienkiewicz at some point. I can tell I'm sort of winging it because I don't have anything on my test sheet. I haven't tested a color on it yet. Just tested one. Oh, now I'm listening to this really cool album by this woman who went by the name of A Girl Called Eddie. Sort of retro-ish. Back to, I don't know, if a female singing Burt Bacharach songs, I guess, is the best way I can think to put it. And not Dionne Warwick, Caucasian female. haven't looked to see if anybody's making comments or anything yet. It looks like maybe somebody has. So sorry if I haven't said anything. I'm facing away from the table at my, or the place where my computer is. Oh, and now I think I have the dramatics coming on. Actually, this, yeah, I think it must be. I mean, I guess it could be some instrumental Isaac Hayes, because I have his Black Moses in there right now. I can't remember everything that's on it, because I sort of got into him in one short space of time, a whole bunch of albums. I don't know, it sounds a little bit too fast-paced to be him, so I'm gonna guess it's from this dramatics. Yep, that's what it was. Holy crap. Bradley, I'll get to your question in a little while, but Larry, I did not know your mom worked on the cover for that. That's pretty damn amazing. It's a pretty iconic cover, that's for sure. now I'm going to have to go find the liner notes for that album to see if I can find a Palestina in there. That was a little bit too wet there, but that's fine. I can get rid of some of it. Now I think I have Beach House playing. Isn't this exciting? Watching me paint teeny tiny silver beads on a necklace. You must be squirming in your seats. I tell you, if you like those sort of lush, kind of old Burt Bacharach sounding kind of things, you should go look for this Girl Called Eddie. It's really good. The whole album's really good. It's got like the horns and everything. And she has a nice voice. Girl Called Eddie, why don't you make another album? There are parts on this Diodato album that sound a little bit like the person I just mentioned in parts, and I think that's actually what I'm listening to at the moment. I think I can tell by some of the synthesizer type sounds in the background, and now this flute, which is probably all irrelevant to you, just I'm just blathering about. Ooh, and now it's Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Bombast Incorporated. I just know that if I listen back to some of these live recordings that I'm making, I just really want to hide my head somewhere. Talking about what I'm saying, that stuff. Not necessarily what I'm painting. Thank you. Ooh, now it's Philip Glass. From Glassworks, circa something like, I don't know, 80. Actually, yeah, probably like about 1980-ish. I was lucky enough to see him live way back around that time. And I remember it was pretty neat. It was all kind of new to me. Ooh, now it's Devo. That's some kind of segue from Philip Glass to Devo. Down the alley. Her name was Sally. Oh, down the street. Got the words wrong. In the alley. Her name was Sally. I never touched her. She never saw it. She's hit by space junk. In New York. Miami Beach. Oh, this is fun. Angola. Saudi Arabia. Anybody can sing along to Devo. Sputnik. Africa. India. Venezuela. Texas. Kansas. Oh, that first Devo album, that's something else. Keeps coming. All right, I've been putting it off. Now I guess I have to do these damn tattoos. A nice, simple portrait until you get to the tattoos. But I guess they sort of made him what he was, so I better do them. Ooh, now it's good old MTV fodder. It's Peter Gabriel's Shock the Monkey. This was such a cool video for its time. Through the fire, I must change, and if I'm on my knees, talk about me, darling, please. Hey, 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 monkey, 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 don't you know you gotta shock the monkey? Faster, fast, right on the rocks. Don't you monkey with the monkey. Like it, but I guess I'm lying. Monkey. Watch a monkey get hurt, monkey. For the swine. Okay. And the news is breaking. song takes me back, Shock the Monkey. When MTV was new and actually interesting. And now it's Brian Ferry. I don't know, I feel stupid saying who's on here, considering you can't hear it. Temptation. Huh. Oh, you still want to know what I'm listening to? Well, I'll tell you. It's the Flower Kings. Now I'm listening to Peter Frampton before he became huge. This is what's the technical term for what I'm doing is noodling. Doing a bunch of tiny little teeny weeny details. Although noodling actually sort of means doing, I think, a little somewhat unnecessary, extraneous, show-offy details. And now I'm listening to Dada, a band I think was pretty good that had a few hits and then just sort of went away. Sorry if the phone's shaking. The thing I have it attached to is sitting beside the table. So anytime the table moves, the phone's gonna move. I might be calling this done in a few minutes. We can move along. Dun, 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 dun. Either way, me all alone. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sorry about your eye. Find a way to make amends. This is what's called noodling, and what I'm doing now. So that we can have a home. I swear that I can make you happy. I know that that ain't so easy. Where would you go anyway? These headphones are starting to hurt. That's a definite indication that I've been doing this for too long. So easy, 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 so easy. erase some of the pencil lines, and I may add the tiniest bit of highlight here and an eye. Hopefully it ends up not looking too gimmicky. Back to Miles Davis. Anyone that watches my videos knows that when I say I'm done, there's always something else to do. Done. No, wait, done. No, no, wait, no, done. Yes, no. Yeah, I think I'll be done. So anyway, I'll check the feed to see if I need to comment or anything. Thanks for anyone that watched, commented, shared, and I'll see you next time.